and disable annotation you need to do.
Where can I find it, sir?
Sir, once you share the screen, that time you will get the disable annotation on YouTube.
I am not going to share my screen, sir. Yes, sir. I have arranged it on my wall.
Yes, sir.
So, shall I start, sir?
Yes, sir. Start sharing because already we have delayed by 5 minutes.
1 second, sir. Record to this computer. Okay, good afternoon, students. Let me. Is it recording, sir? Sandeep, sir?
Recording is started, sir. Sharing screen is not started.
No. I am not sharing my screen, sir. I am going to explain it on the board.
Okay, sir.
Okay, on the wall, I have arranged
fine.
One.
Okay, sir. Fine, sir.
Right. Thank you. Good afternoon, students. Once again, welcome to Engineering Graphics Online Revision Classes. So before getting into the topics, let me give you an idea on the pattern that we are going to follow to cover maximum number of topics. In fact, we have given only 6 days, 1 hour on each day. So 6 hours together we are having for engineering graphics. So however, Lakshman Rao sir has sent you the PPT for first unit. So you can go through the PPT and you can practice the topics in first unit. So I'm going to start the second unit now. That is orthographic projections. Orthographic projections of points. So you know the topics that are available in second unit. Those are projections of points, straight lines and projections of planes. So these are the three topics that we have in second unit. Again, projections of points is very easy. So you can learn on your own by going through the notes or the regular class notes. So straight away, I'm starting with projections of points. No, sorry, projections of straight lines. So coming to straight lines, projections or orthographic projections means we are locating the given object, that is straight line, in the given quadrant or with respect to horizontal plane and vertical plane. So there are 4 or 5 brief positions that a straight line can have with respect to horizontal and vertical planes that we know. A straight line can be parallel to both HP, VP. And the second one is a straight line parallel to one and perpendicular to the other. A straight line parallel to one and inclined to the other. And the fourth one, a straight line is contained by one or both HP, VP. Finally, a straight line inclined to both HP and VP. So, in maximum number of cases, if you verify the previous examination question papers, we are getting the questions from fifth case, that is a straight line is inclined to both HP and VP. So the earlier positions are not that much necessary, but however, while discussing the fifth case or fifth position, we will cover all the remaining three. So, first of all, let me give you a question. A line AB, which is 100 mm, a line AB, 100 mm, is inclined to both HP and VP. So, the line is inclined at 30 degrees to HP. So the angle with HP is denoted by theta, we know. The angle with VP is denoted by phi, that is say 45 degrees. So once again, I'm giving you the statement of the problem. A line AB of 100 mm long is inclined at 30 degrees to the horizontal plane and inclined at 45 degrees to VP. And one end of the line A is 10 mm in front of VP and say 20 mm above HP. So length of the line AB is 100. The angle with HP is 30 degrees. Angle with VP is 45. One end position is given, that is end A position is clearly mentioned, which is such as 10 mm in front of VP and 20 mm above the HP. So this is how it was given in the statement. So now we have to draw the projections. So once again, I'm repeating the question. Draw the projections of a straight line AB of 100 mm long, which is inclined at 30 degrees to HP and 45 degrees to VP. When one end of A is 20 mm above the HP and 10 mm in front of VP. Now, we have to start the solution like this. First, we have to draw the XY line. Now, from the given data, as one end position is clearly known, first I am marking that particular point, which is 20 mm above and 10 mm in front of. So A position is clearly given. So I have given the positions for end A, 20 mm above the HP, 10 mm in front of VP. And afterwards, when you observe these two positions, the line is having two different inclinations with the two. There are two inclined positions. Dear students, don't chat the unnecessary topics now because we have very less time. I'm sorry. Okay. When a line is inclined, we know that there will be a reduced length in the final position. So when a line is 30 degrees with HP, the shape is going to be reduced on 30, proportional to 30 degrees. Similarly, when a line is 45 degrees to VP, on VP also we are going to get the reduced length. So for starting up the solution, you are allowed to take only one angle at a time. For which what I am doing is, I am taking phi is equal to 0 as the first assumption. So I am going to consider one angle, that is 30 degrees with HP. At the same time, I am assuming that the line is parallel to VP. So 30 degrees angle will be taken on horizontal plane like this. This is 100 mm, that is true length. B dash, A dash, B dash is the true length at an angle of theta is equal to 30 degrees. Now, the corresponding reduced length will be coming on horizontal plane as AB. So this is reduced length. So true length is on VP, reduced length is on HP. And this reduced length is just because of the angle of 30 degrees with HP. Now I'm going with the second assumption, phi is equal to 45 degrees. Phi is equal to 45 degrees. That means the angle with VP. So we know that the angle with VP can be shown on horizontal plane. Similarly, angle with HP on VP and vice versa. So 30 degrees angle is making with horizontal plane, which we have shown on VP. Now the angle of 45 degrees that it is making with VP, so we have to show it on horizontal plane. So on horizontal plane again, I'm taking say B1 as 100 mm, that is true length. The corresponding reduced length can be seen in V1 dash on VP. Right? Here, if you see, if you observe, my dear students, there are two front views, two top views. In fact, out of the two front views, one front view is having with true length, the other view with reduced length. Similarly, there are two top views. One top view is with true length, the other one is with reduced length. By the way, if you observe, both the reduced lengths, if you observe both in front view and top view, they are parallel to XY. They are parallel to XY. Why they are parallel to XY? As you have assumed that the line is parallel to VP in first assumption and the line is parallel to HP in second assumption, the reduced lengths have come parallel to XY. In fact, they are not supposed to be parallel to XY. Then what we have to do? So we have to take two locus lines at the true positions. I mean, this is true length with true angle. So I am calling it as true position. So this is true position in front view. This is true length. And this is also a true angle because it was given. So true length with true angle. So this is also, I'm terming it as true position in top view. True position in front view, true position in top view. So now these two reduced lengths, which are parallel, will be transferred to the locus lines. In fact, we have to make a note that it is locus of B in front view, and this is locus of B in top view, right? So the parallel line in front view, it is parallel to XY just because of our assumption and assumption alone. Now what we are doing is, we are revealing that assumption, what we made earlier. So now I am turning or tilting this parallel line to the locus line where it is actually. So this is B2 dash. B1 dash should be transferred to the locus line by taking A dash as center, A dash B1 dash radius. You tilt it to the locus line. This is B2 dash. Now join A2 dash B2 dash. This is final front view. Final front view. Similarly, this is the parallel line, parallel to XY with reduced length, which is not supposed to be like this. Timely, it is parallel to XY because of our assumption. Now I am going to transfer it or tilt it to its original position, which is locus of B in top view. So with A as center, AB radius, I am tilting it to the locus line. This is a B2. Now join AB2. This is final top view. So final front view and final top view should be drawn dark. And here there is a facility for this kind of problems. You can verify whether your answer is right or wrong. So how you can verify? If you draw a perpendicular projector or vertical projector that will pass through B2 dash and B2. If the two points are coming on a vertical projector, you can say that your answer is perfectly correct. Suppose if any one point is not coming, then there may be mistakes that you have to verify. You have to go back and verify. So this is how you can solve the projections of lines problem. Here, suppose if the examiner asks you to find the traces. Now what I am doing is, here we have two final views. Final front view, that is A dash B2 dash. Final top view, A B2. Now, no doubt AB2 or A'B2' is final front view, which is in VP. So now extend this final front view to the XY line. Wherever it is touching the ground is H. Here we have to draw one vertical line on both sides of XY. And now you have to extend the final top view till the vertical line drawn at H. So wherever it meets, that will be horizontal trace. So here H is front view point, HT is top view point. Horizontal trace will be always coming on horizontal plane, which can be seen in top view. So HT is top view point, but H is front view point. So H dash, A dash, B2 dash will come on the same straight line. Similarly, if you want to find the vertical trace now, So in order to get the vertical trace, AB2 should be extended till XY line. Fortunately, it was already extended. You have to verify wherever it is touching the XY line, that is V. At V, you have to draw one vertical line again so that it meets the projected line of final front view at a particular point. Right? First and foremost, you have to extend the final top view till the XY line. As you are working from horizontal plane, that represents vertical trace. So when you extend this final top view, it will meet the XY line at some particular point. You mark it as V. And at V, you just draw one perpendicular line or perpendicular projector that will meet the projected line of final front view at a point, that is VT. Now, here vertical trace is front view point, V is top view point. Again, if you check H dash, here it is XY line, it is there on XY line, H dash, VT dash, A dash, B2 dash are coming on the same.
Students, you have got to wait for 2 minutes. Satish sir has lost power cut is there at his place, so he will be joining soon.
Lakshman sir, Sandeep here sir. Sir, you can unmute yourself. Hello, Lakshmanram sir, Sandeep here. So you can unmute yourself and start taking class.
Right, sir. Yes, dear students, can you hear me? Yes.
Yes, sir, the students are able to hear me.
Hello?
Sir, the students are able to hear you,
sir.
And
your screen
is being
shared. Are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir.
Now, this is the second problem which I wanted to take. There, are you hearing, please? Yes. Now, this will be your next problem in the straight lines. Now he has given true length of the straight line as AB, capital AB, 75 mm, and the AB top view length he has given as 65 mm. True length is 75, top view length is 65, and front view length is 50. These things are have been shown here. True length AB is A dash B1 dash 75 mm. Top view length is A dash B dash 50 mm. And he has given A is, one end A is in HP. When it is in HP, it is not above HP. Therefore, I say it is at zero height. Height of capital A from HP is zero. It is 15 mm in front. That is what is given in the problem. In the problem, data given is length of straight line, actual length is 75. Front view length is A dash B dash, that is 50 mm. Top view length is 65. Three lengths he has given: true length, front view length, top view length. And the end of the straight line is, it is on HP. Height is zero from HP. Then front view, it is 15 mm. He is asking us to find out all the four angles. Now, first what we do is, first I draw a reference line XY. From XY, I take AB length as 50 mm. Front view length is A dash B2 dash. That is front view length. It is have started here. That is equal to 50. Whereas top view length is 65. It is 15 from reference line. Front view length is on HP. Therefore, it is on reference line XY. A dash B2 dash is on XY. It is 15 mm in front. Therefore, from XY, I draw a vertical line. It is 15 mm. At this point, I draw a line parallel to XY. A dash B1 dash A, B1 is 65. Draw a reference line. On reference line, draw A dash B2 dash equal to 50 mm. From XY, come forward 15 mm. It is 15 mm in front. Mark AB1 equal to 65. This is data given. Now, here we draw parallel lines. From here, he has not given the angle, but true length he has given. He has not given the angle. If he has given angle, I would have drawn the angle. Now, he has given me the true length. Now, A lies on a perpendicular from A dash. In the previous problem, if you see, A lies on a perpendicular to A dash. Similarly, B also should lie on a perpendicular from B to dash. B must lie on a perpendicular from B to dash. A lies on a perpendicular from A dash. B also must lie on a perpendicular from B to dash. Therefore, what I do is, at B dash, I draw a perpendicular. A has centered 75 mm, I cut it at B1. So, here I got B. From A perpendicular A, B dash perpendicular, I get B. Now, this I name it as B2. This is true length. And what will be this angle? The angle made by true length with XY is? There are four angles. Which angle is this? This is the true angle made by the top view. True angle made by the top view is this angle. And that will be above is theta, below is phi. So this is angle phi. Now, from here, from B1, I draw another perpendicular. From here also, I cut 75. So here I get theta. Once again, I go back. First, draw reference line XY. On XY, mark A dash B2 dash 50 mm. Come forward 15 mm. AB1 equal to 65. This is given in the data, please. I'm not doing anything. From B2, I draw a perpendicular to get B2. From B1, I draw a perpendicular to get B1 dash. See, from A dash, if I draw a perpendicular, I get A. From B2 dash, if I draw a perpendicular, I get B2. From B1, if I draw a perpendicular, I get B1 dash. So first what I do is, I have drawn a perpendicular from B dash, A as center, 60, 75 cutoff. I got B2 here. B2 here. This will be B2. From B1, I draw a perpendicular. A dash, I take 75. From B1, I draw a perpendicular. From A dash, I cut off 75. This is B1 dash. This is true length. This angle is theta. This angle is theta. This angle is phi. Now, once you get theta, phi and true length, rest of the things is whatever Sir has told in the previous problem. What is that? Here you draw, at B1 dash you draw a locus, at B2 you draw a locus. At B1 dash you draw a locus, at B2 you draw a locus. Now, AS center, AB1 radius, draw an arc. AS center, AB1 radius, draw an arc. A dash S center, A dash B dash radius, draw another arc. Now, this we will see here. A dash as center, this radius, draw an arc. A as center, this radius, draw another arc. This cuts locus at B, this cuts locus at B dash. This is the final figure. Final figure is A dash, B1 dash, true length, AB2, true length, AB is apparent length, A dash, B dash is apparent length. This angle is theta, B1 dash, A dash, Y is theta, B dash, A dash, Y is alpha. Now here, 48.22 is phi, 59.36 is beta. And traces, you can extend BA. This is, I don't know whether I have given it or not. Yes, traces when B dash A dash is extended, this is H dash. If I draw a perpendicular, this becomes A itself will become H. The trace coincides with A. Here also this vertical trace coincides with A dash. Now H dash is here, H is here. Now extend BA, extend BA, it cuts at V. Extend BA, it cuts XY at V. From V, draw a perpendicular, extend B dash A dash, that cuts at V dash. Now V dash is vertical trace, capital H is horizontal trace. B dash is vertical trace, capital H is horizontal trace. This way, dear students, I have already sent all the PPTs to some CRs, not all CRs, some CRs I have sent, and I have told them to pass on to all the sections. Now, here you can see there are many problems. Next problem is this. Now, distance between N projectors is 50 mm. P is 25 above, 15 in front. Q is 60 above, 70 in front. Draw projections and traces of PQ, determine the angles. He has given distance between N projectors. What are the N projectors here? End projector is one end projector is this. If I join a line from B dash to B, this will be another projector. That we'll see here. First is, he has given distance between projectors 50. P is 25 above, 15 in front. Let me draw this first. I will draw this as first. Draw reference line XY. Draw a reference line XY. Draw a vertical line. P dash is 25 above. This is above symbol, please. P dash is 25 above. P is 15 in front. P dash is 25 above. P is 15 in front. Distance between projectors is 50. From here, you mark 50. Draw one more perpendicular. Now, distance between end projectors is 50. P dash is 25 above. P 15 in front. Now, Q is 60 above and Q is 70 in front. So first, what you do, draw a reference line XY, draw, take a point, draw a perpendicular, P dash 25 above, P 15 in front. From here, mark 50 mm, draw another perpendicular. This will be Q dash is 60 above, Q is 70 in front. Now I got P dash, Q dash, PQ. These are final projections, not initial projections. These are final projections. Now, what is this angle? This is alpha, this angle is beta. Now I have to find out true length and theta and phi. This is reverse of our first problem. This is reverse of our first problem. Now what should I do? At P dash, draw a horizontal line. At P dash, P, draw horizontal lines. At Q dash and Q, draw locus. This is what I am going to draw now. At P dash, I draw a line parallel to HP. At P, I draw a line parallel to VP. At Q dash, draw locus of Q dash. At Q, draw locus of Q. This is exactly reverse of our first problem. So I have drawn. First, again I go back, draw XY, draw a perpendicular, mark P dash Q. From here, mark 50 mm, mark Q dash Q. At P dash, draw a line parallel to HP. At P, draw a line parallel to VP. Now, draw at Q dash, draw locus of Q dash. At Q, draw locus of Q. Now, we come down to how to get Q to Q2. Now, P dash as center, radius equal to P dash Q dash, draw an arc, cutting line parallel to HP at Q2 dash. P dash S center, radius P dash Q dash, draw an arc at Q2 dash. Similarly, P S center, PQ radius, draw an arc. P S center, okay, I think I will show you it later on. I'm continuing with this. I'm continuing from Q dash, draw a perpendicular. From Q dash, draw a perpendicular up to this. That will be Q2. If I join PQ2, that is true length. From Q2 dash, draw a perpendicular cutting locus at Q2, join PQ2, that will be true length. Join PQ2, that will be the true length. Now similarly, PS center, PQ radius, draw an arc up to Q1, from Q1, produce it to Q1 dash. Now, P dash Q1 dash is true length, PQ2 is also true length. P dash Q1 dash is true length, PQ2 dash is also true length. They must be equal. This line and this line length must be equal. This is theta, 33 is alpha, 42 is phi, 47 is beta. True length, I think I did not give you the true length. You have to measure. Now, extend to get traces, extend Q dash P dash to H, extend QP to V and produce it. At V, draw a perpendicular, at H draw perpendicular. At V, draw a perpendicular, cutting at capital V dash, H dash, draw a perpendicular H. H is horizontal trace, V dash is vertical trace. All angles are given. True length is 81.9. That becomes approximately 82. Dear students, this way I have got some more problems. You can go through them. There are many problems. What I wish is, today, please go through straight lines. Some of the problems of the straight lines, you get go through. You find any problem which you are not able to understand with the PPT, please give me a WhatsApp call. All of you know my role, cell number, I think. Cell number is, if you want, you can note down, 9866 416 517. Yes, and I'm not able to send a message here. Anyway, CRs, they know it. I want all the CRs. If you have not shared the PPTs to all the students, please share them. Please share. CSC, CF students, they have it. ABC also may have it. Because I've already shared to ABC sections, C and F. I don't know whether G people also have it. E, D, G, IT students. If you have not got it, please call other CR, take them and put it in your respective groups so that all the students will get PPTs of complete drawing. Okay? So tomorrow we'll see planes. I want you to see straight lines PPTs today. You must see. If there is any problem which you do not understand, that problem number and PPT name, you give it to me so that I will try to explain to the few people on another meeting, please. Not on this. This is not available to us. Private Zoom meeting, I'll call. Is it clear? And I want some students to answer. I'm not able to. Yes. Sorry, I think I did not record this. Yes. Yes, mid size, so far we do not know. I've already told your CRs to talk to coordinator. I'm not sure what they have done. Yes, Akshada, are you available? Akshada, Kruti? Yes, sir. Ah, yes, sir, it will be over.